youngster has told me so, I seem about as much fighting as a good learning man. And I think there's still a bit of fight left in me yet, if I get the chance to go out again. I was already in the army when the war broke out, and went to France on August 13th, 1914, 9 days after the declaration of war. The first big scrap we had was at Mons, the 12 o'clock Sunday noon. The Germans don't take any count of Sunday. You people over here don't realise what our boys went through in those days. That march from Mons was a nightmare. Unless you've been through it, you can't imagine what an agonising time it was. We used to do from 20 to 25 miles a day. We filled our haversacks with biscuits and ate them as we marched along. The longest march we had was from Jury-on-the-Aisne to La Bassée. That was after we had advanced on the Marne and started to push the Germans back to the Aisne. We were sent out to relieve the French at La Bassée. It might have been 40 miles. At any rate, we started off on the 4th March early in September. It was a Saturday morning, and reached La Bassée Sunday dinner time to relieve the French. We had a 4-hour sit down, and then we went straight into action in open formation. That was when we pushed them back 15 miles in 3 weeks. I remember September the 30th too. It was the day we drew the first pay since we'd been out there, 5 francs. We had to last as long as we could make it. No more pay until November. 5 francs from August until November, and bread was a franc alone. There was only one thing you could cheer us up on the march, that was singing. We used to sing Tipperary choruses, invented by some of the chaps. Tipperary was in full swing then, and they'd always gone to something they'd invented themselves. It used to buck us up, and we would march all the better for it. Sometimes we'd sing some of T.H. Eliot's songs, you know, the chocolate-coloured tunes. But we'd always go into something we'd invented. I don't think I've got much of a voice for singing, but I'd try and sing one or two of the choruses we used to sing. We're here because we're here, because we're here, because we're here. We're here because we're here, because we're here, because we're here. We see far.
Up to mighty London came an Irishman one day. As the streets are paved with gold, sure everyone was gay. Singing songs of Piccadilly, Strand and Leicester Square, till Paddy got excited, then he shouted to them there. It's a long way to Tipperary, it's a long way to go. It's a long way to Tipperary, to the sweetest girl I know. Goodbye, Piccadilly, farewell, Leicester Square. It's a long, long way to Tipperary, but my heart's right there.
It's a long way to Tipperary, it's a long way to go. It's a long way to Tipperary, to the sweetest girl I know in Tipperary. So it's goodbye, Piccadilly, farewell, Leicester Square. It's a long, long way to Tipperary, but my heart's right there.
Paddy wrote a letter to his Irish Molly O, saying, should you not receive it, write and let me know. If I make
smile, 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 while you balloon the blood to light your fag. Smile, boys, that's the style. What's the use of worrying? It never was worthwhile. Oh, pack up, get up, loot in your old kit bag, and smile, smile, smile. Private Cook went a-marching into Flanders with his smile, his sunny smile. He was loved by the privates and commanders for his smile, his sunny smile. funny smile. When the throng of Germans came along with a mighty swing, Turk yelled out, "This little bunch is mine. Keep your heads down, boys, and sing." Back up your troubles in your old kit bag and smile, smile, smile. While you balloon the puzzle light your fag, smile, boys, that's the style. What's the use of worrying? It never was worthwhile. Oh, pack up your troubles in your old kit bag and smile, smile.
Country found them ready at the stirring call for men. Let no tears add to their hardships as the soldiers pass along. And although your heart is breaking, make it sing this cheery song. A nation in distress, and we gave our glorious laddies on our battles to no less. For no gallant son of freedom to a tyrant's yoke should bend, and a noble heart must answer to the sacred call of a friend. Keep the home fires burning while your hearts are yearning, though your lads are far away.
They shall grow not old, as we who are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them.